fresh fire. Come on, walk with me today. Come into the room that Jesus built, in the house where God is. The kingdom of God, the kingdom of heaven is where God is. And God lives with his people. Those who know him. We not only know him, he's here now in the spirit. Those who are born again, well, we know God. We know that God lives together with us. The third temple, where is it? Who are we in Christ? Come on, Musa Wafula, I see you coming in. Pam Dawson, I see you coming in. Come on, we're not going to be on Facebook too much more longer, any more days. Glory to God. We're walking into the day that God made. The first and the last day together now. Share the broadcast. If you hear the word, speaking by the Spirit. Come on, Chris Burton. See you coming in. Glory to God. Let's activate the kingdom of God. For the kingdom of God is within you. The temple priest. Come on. There's only one high priest. There's only one king. There's only one God. There's only one way to know God. There's only one Holy Spirit of God. There's only one earth. There's only one heaven. There's only one place. And you can find God. He's not lost. He's here right now. Come on, say, I'm moving into the transitioning, transfigurating with God today, knowing God in the completion of time, that God has fulfilled everything. Come on, Pam Dawson, through Jesus, the shadow who built the house, where you go to church, what body, a group of people are you agreeing with? Who you with now? Who's your friends? Who's your neighbors? Who's your family member? Who set us all free? One man, Jesus. Come on, glory to God. They built this thing, the Dome of the Rock. War is over there, glory to God, over a place, a building built by the hands of man. The temple was crumbled. Come on, it's already been done. They're praying still on the wall. We're walking through the wall of separation outside of heaven, outside of Jerusalem, where Jesus was born. Come on, in Bethlehem. We know the word. We know where God is. He's alive in you and me. It's time to waken the dawn. It's time to waken the dead in Christ first. It's time to walk into the goodness of God in the land of the living. It's time to manifest and raise the dead in Christ first by the first fruits of the only begotten Son, Jesus. It's time to open up your mouth and let God speak. It's time to unify. It's time to unite the love revolutionary movement of God. It's time to revolt. It's time to stand together with God. It's time to sit in the heavenly places. It's time to manifest the goodness of God in your life. You are the house that God built off the foundation of his own blood. You blood washed, spirit filled, fire baptized. Come on, we're in the rejuvenation of God's dream. We're walking the manifestation of God's kingdom. We're manifesting heaven on the earth. We're the new earth of the new heaven with the righteous King. Jesus is Lord. He is God. He's the Savior to the world. He's the manifested glory in your life. He's the Holy Spirit in each one of you now. I come to speak to your inner man. I come to manifest the glory of God together with all of you. Come on, we're not divided. We're rightfully just standing together with God. We're on the right side. Come on, we're on the right and the left. We're in the midst of now. We're in the midst of time. We got the royal family. We're the royal kingdom. We're the full house. We got the full hand. We're going all in. We got the casino. Glory to God. We got the house on the hill built by God in Jesus. Come on, put your chips in. It's judgment day. You can judge the Spirit of God in the preacher. Judge me. See if I'm speaking by Holy Spirit, God's Spirit. I speak in the name of Jesus Christ, resurrected up by the Holy Ghost, by the Holy Spirit of Pentecost, by the Holy Spirit of God the Father, by the Holy Spirit of God the Son, set free to know God. I know God because he lives in the church. We have the gospel. It's going to shock you. Glory to God. We're speaking right now on every phone and every airway and every technology thing that man made. And we're the mankind of the Christ King, the anointed one, Son, fully flesh, fully man, fully alive in the Spirit right now. Come on, it's Pentecost. What's lost in Pentecost is the unity of the faith of the brothers and sisters sitting together with God through Jesus Christ. Come on, it's time to get the voice of fire. International Church, your church, my church, his church. We're the church on fire. Come on, it's now your time to transition. Who am I talking to now? It's our time together with God. Hallelujah. We're a new man in Christ. We're new men and women together. We're the family, God, having the full revelation with the wisdom of the Spirit of God. God's alive in you. Never give up. His yoke is easy. His burden is light. Come on, I'm just activating things. Activision. Come on. I got the vision of the Word of God. I got the Spirit of God. I can see the future hope of the salvation of mankind. I can see Jesus coming back in the church in the full body. We're in the kingdom of the royal family, of the heavenly host of the Most High God. Come on. I come to multi-nation by one die. Come on, we died together with God in Jesus. He's manifesting the best. Lights, camera, action. Who are we talking to now? We manifest the glory of God. It's time for the final roar. It's time for the final step. It's time for the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. It's time for you to activate. It's time for the transformation nation. It's time for you to put on your cape. It's time for you to Superman. Yes, you can. Ain't no kryptonite gonna hold me down. It's time to be the supernatural power of God. And understand we're in the family of God. Through one man, Christ Jesus, we're the new man in Christ. We're just activating things in 2022. I'm trying to tell you, glory to God, as I am, so are you. Through Jesus Christ, we're the same as it once was, is. It's time for the great awakening of the move of God. It's time to open up your mouth and decree and declare the works of the power of God. It's time for you to seek God for who He is in your mouth. It's time for you to activate the faith of the children of God. It's time for you to walk in the blessings of Abraham. It's time for you to manifest all things by the baptism of fire. It's time for you to get baptized in the good dirt of the good earth that God made the last man standing on the Word of God preaching. It's time for you to have dominion power. It's time for you to be the lion of the line of the tribe of Israel. It's time for you to be the continent of the Word of God speakers. It's time for you to manifest heaven on the dirt of the earth of the ground that God made. It's time for you to manifest heaven with God. God's alive with you right now. If you hear these words, I'm speaking by the Holy Spirit of the Word. It's time to release the sound. It's time to release the rock and the roll of Jesus. Come on, Elvis was the king of rock and roll down in Memphis, Tennessee. I've got the rock and roll with Jesus. He moved the stone away. It's time to know the stone was written down in stone. The lightning waves of God. You're hidden in Christ. You're not hiding anymore. You're coming out of darkness. You're from the land of the tribe of Judah. You're from the mountaintop of God. You're in the latter rain glory of God. Like unto the days of God's folk and built a boat with Noah. You got the lightning rays of God. You're in the latter rain glory. You're manifesting the upcoming fire. The upcoming, come on. I'm in the fire, the baptism of the love of God. I'm in the word of faith by the structure of God, by the mankind, by the Christ King, all women and men and children, no matter what mother, no matter what father, you whatever what land you live in now, we live in the land of the house of God that Jesus built. Hallelujah! We manifest in God's kingdom. We're coming together in unity. We're coming together with a creation of time, with the God of creation, restored all things into the new day. Into, come on, just have peace, relax. It's a new day now. It's time for you to activate the faith with the children of the Most High God. You got a voice of fire. You got a voice to you. Come on, you got the regenerated mind of God through Jesus. Jesus is the first and the last and the first. You got the sound of the wave of God. You got the eternal glorification of God's word. You are the new eternal spirit man. You are activating the faith of the word of God by the children of God, by the Most High God, for we're one spirit, one man, one mind, one place. Come on, right now, say God's alive in us right now, together in us, in each one of us right now. It's time for you to finish the race, finish the work that Paul wrote down in the New Testament. You got the life of the revelation of the Word of God. It's time to unite, glory to God. It's time to unite, glory to God. It's time to rise up together with God in Christ. Christ is the anointed one who gave you the Spirit of God, the Father's blessing of the Spirit of the one who speaks by the heart of God, by the nation. Who am I talking to now? I'm coming in here with fire. I'm coming here with God's breath. I'm coming here with the same breath God breathed in the first man, Adam, set free by the last man, Jesus. I know the name of the Father and the name of the Son having the same Spirit. Hallelujah. It's our day, our time now. Faith is speaking. Faith is alive. We're the children of the host of the revelation, the army of the host of the angelic ones who are new creations, all things new now. Everything that once fell against God the Father has been brought back to position at the right hand of the Father through the right hand of fellowship by the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. We speak now together with God as God speaks together with us, having the same mind, spirit, body that God created us to be in the first man from the last man, Jesus, now set free from the curse of death itself on my flesh man preaching by my spirit man, unified by one completed man with the mind of the Spirit of Jesus, with the body of the Christ King, by the body of God and the mind of God through Jesus. having the foreknowledge of the foreknowledge of the foretaste of the Holy Spirit speaking. Your spirit being unified with us. We're all wonderfully, uniquely made in Christ Jesus. Standing together with God our Father. Having the same faith of the same spirit of the same one who saved us all, y'all. Fresh fire. I come to preach above my natural carnal mind. I come to preach above my natural carnal ways. I come to preach above everything that ever once was that fell against God the Father. And only through God the Son can you know God the Father, having the same mind spirit Jesus had. Jesus is the life of the kingdom of God. He's the life of the house that God the Father built through God the Son, being blood washed, spirit filled, fire baptized, speaking together with God. Now God speaks out of our inner man. By the Holy Spirit, our spirit unified through the Father to the Son and the Son of the Father, Jesus, and Jesus, the Son and the Father, us all having the same spirit. We are Christians, Christ-like ones, created in the image of God, not to worship an image, not to be against each other, but be the same as Jesus once was and still is. He is the Father's blessing. He is the land of the river Euphrates. He's the river of any river you've ever known. He's the water of life of all known things, of all new creations, standing alone with God, speaking by the Holy Spirit in each one of us. For we all have the same Holy Spirit Jesus had. And Jesus gave us the Father's Spirit, being born again to speak by the Holy Spirit of the revelation of the Word, teaching by the apostolic anointed ones, the foundation through Jesus Christ, the Son of Man. He's the Son of Man. He's the Son of God who became flesh, who fulfilled the word that God spoke to the first man, Adam, and through him and through the last man, Adam, Jesus, we all saved. Come on in to the glory of God. Come on in to the house that God built. We the third temple, not built by the hands of man, but built by the man, Jesus. He set you free from anything you could ever know. Say, I'm free indeed in Jesus. What you free from? I'm free from the curse of death. I'm free from curses. I'm free from Satan. I'm free from back gambling. I'm free from sins I committed yesterday. I'm free from the dark depths of the hell. I'm free from the chains of pointing my finger and condemning anybody. I'm free from anybody condemning me. I'm free from the Satan touching me. I'm free from sickness and death. I'm free from curses. I'm free from the IRS governments of the world. I'm free from everything God said I'm free from. For who the Son sets free is free indeed. Just say, I'm free to speak. I got a freedom of speech. And ain't nobody going to take it away from me. Because God the Father, through God the Son, Jesus, has given himself the Spirit of God in us speaking. When we are born again through Jesus and have the Holy Spirit, the resurrected Spirit, the power of God from the Father to the Son and the Son to the Father of all creation. Now you speaking together as the Spirit of God speaking. You have the written scriptures written down in the holy book called the Holy Bible, the Word of God. Now you speak the Word of God with the author and the finisher of our faith, having the faith of the Son of Man, Jesus, and the Son of God with the Christ King, the anointed one, Son, Spirit, having known the Father, the Word who manifested Jesus. He was the one manifested Word that God spoke and breathed into the Virgin Mary, promised to the Virgin Eve, to the bone of the man, Adam, of all creations, of all things fallen, of the heavens and the earth. We hear now speaking by God's Holy Ghost, his fire, his spirit. God is spirit fire. He speaks in his children who are born again from the last man, Jesus, set free from the curse of the first man, Adam, now speaking by the Holy Spirit. And all of us now, for this generation, knows God. Yes. Hallelujah. Yes. Oh, you're on the phone. Hallelujah. My wife's on the phone upstairs, so let me quiet down. How come I get on here and just get happy? She comes right in here right after that and says, shh, I'm on the phone. Hallelujah. Been here waiting 2 hours to get on here. I love her anyway. Glory to God. I love you, Vinny Dobo. Say, I'm a child of God. Come tell them whoever's on the phone to listen. Tell your husband. He's live right now on Facebook. Who are on the book. Come on, with the face of the earth and with the reflection of God. You can look up into the stars and you ain't going to find God up there. He is not up there. Like the sun reflects to the moon at night and the light comes off the moon at night. We daywalkers, tongue talkers, spirit-filled walkers. We manifest the goodness of God in the land of the living through Jesus Christ. He is the Word of God. He is the Word of the Father, by the Word of the Son, having the same Spirit in us. We are the third man in each other. We love each other greater, for greater is He now alive in each one of us. We have the same Holy Spirit of His Father, who is the same Holy Spirit, the resurrected power of His Son, Jesus. As Jesus became flesh, He represented man. He represented every fallen angel. He represented everything that you could have ever known. For today, you now know God by the same Holy Spirit in Jesus, is the same Holy Spirit of His Father, who is the same Holy Spirit in each one of you who were chosen before the foundation of the world, before God created the moon and the sun, the stars and the earth, and any man that came from the ground of the earth, and any hell or any heaven or anything, God's still here. He's in here by His Spirit. His Spirit's in you and me together through Jesus. Jesus has given you His breath. He's given you the breath of the first man that He created from the sand of the earth. Out the bone of that man came the woman. Them two came together. We came from all of them, and all of us now in heaven, of every spirit that's ever been in a body, through the first man, through the first earth, and the only earth God ever made. We've been right standing together with God through Jesus for over 2,000 years, just didn't know how to speak. Now we know how to preach. We know how to speak because God gave us His breath. He gave us His language of every known tongue from the first Adam, from the first earth, from the first land, from the first bone of that man, and the first bone of anything that ever was before man. Now God has restored everything before man and after mankind still is. We are the seed, the harvest kingdom of the Word of God, teaching preachers of the Spirit of God through Jesus. And Jesus gave us His Father's Spirit in the Holy Land of God. Now you in the land of time, preaching by the Holy Spirit of Jesus Christ, resurrected up with the Father, sitting in heaven on the earth, right here. God's here now. Where is He? He's in your life. He's in your life through Jesus. If you believe in Jesus, you have the Holy Spirit of the Father's promise to Adam and Eve in the first earth and the last earth, still speaking from the dirt of the ground of the sand of the land of the harvest of the kingdom of the manifold wisdom of the power of the Spirit of God. If you are a preacher anointed by Jesus, believing fully in the Son of Man, who is the Son of God, having received now the gift of eternal life and your spirit going knowing God today, you open up your mouth and speak the word of faith by the faith of the Son of Man, by the faith of the Word of God. The Son of God has given you the word by the Holy Spirit in Him. Now the Holy Spirit in His Father is the same Holy Spirit in us. We here now on the earth, representing all of heaven, representing all of earth, representing everything that fell in heaven of the angelic beings, representing all of hell, wherever Jesus went before us, we now here with Jesus. Jesus is the word of faith by the faith of the Father God, have received now the same Spirit only by faith. We speak by faith, preach by faith, and by faith of the word of fire, by the Holy Spirit fire who spoke to Moses. That's God the Father, who the Jews, and God of creation through the Son. Jesus has given us the Spirit. We the house of the foundation of God's word. We the house that Jesus built with the Father God and the Son of God, for we built our house on the solid rock of the foundation of Jesus. In the death, burial, and resurrection up of the power of the Spirit. Our spirit now knowing God the Father speaks through God the Son, having faith in them, and our spirit unified with God. Now God, through Jesus Christ, has given you the spirit of reconciliation of all things known and all things not known. Now being known today, it is your day of salvation to hear a preaching by the Spirit of Jesus and the Holy Spirit of His Father. As you now see and hear, the same Spirit in you is the same Spirit in Jesus, who's also in me, who's also in His Father, who's in us, the church. We are the church, representation of the glory of God on the earth, just as Jesus Christ is King in heaven. He's the King of all things in hell. He's the King of all things of angels. He's the King of all things that fail. He's King of kings and Lord of lords. He's God. He is the Son of God, Jehovah. He is Jesus Christ, and the name given to you to preach above all things right now by the same Spirit speaking. So if I speak to you any other way than the cross that Jesus purchased and the land of the river of time, we are in the water of the living God, water of Jesus. Drink and be thirsty. Drink the cup of the flow of love of God. Drink the land of the blood of God. For we are the blood talkers, spirit-filled walkers, talking together in my flesh with the flesh of the Son of Man, fully believing in Jesus Christ who did. He came, my flesh and man sin, my flesh and mind sin, my flesh and carnal mind of sin. He destroyed the devil in my mind. He destroyed my mind of separation from God. And I have been communicating with God's holy fire. I fear God the Father and I fear God the Son. When I start talking this way, there's only one way to pray. There's only one way to know God, is that's to seek God's first, His kingdom. For His kingdom is preaching out of our spirit man, born again through the man Jesus and the God Christ King. He's alive in our flesh. He's alive in our mind. He's alive within us speaking. So when you speak God's word, only through Jesus, blood-wise, spirit-filled, fire-baptized, with his Father's blessing, your spirit, now knowing God, is here now with us. And every one of you on the earth, as you still alive, remaining as a representation of all of God's creations. Have I got your attention? Glory to God. Rise up, church. This is the day of the Lord. This is judgment day. This is the day you judge the preacher and you judge everything he says out of his mouth. For out of the mouth comes the word of God from the promises of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, the God of the Gentiles and the Jews. Jesus Christ set us all free to be the living sacrifice of the living word, of the living tree, of the knowledge of the Father God and the knowledge of the Son of God, having the same Spirit of God who's speaking right now. Who's speaking? God the Father through God the Son and his Spirit unified with our Spirit speaking. Who can preach God's word? We all can do all things together with him through Jesus Christ. For Jesus Christ is the anointed one, set us all free from the mind, separated mind of each other and the mind of Satan and the mind of the world of the doctrines of the false teaching of the traditional teachings of men. Today you are baptized by the water of life, Jesus, having the Holy Spirit of his Father, having believing in him fully in the fullness of time, in the latter rain glory of the glorification of the Father through the Son and the life of the Spirit in your life. If you speak God's word by the Holy Spirit of the word written in the Holy Bible, for the Holy Scriptures were written to know the author and the finisher of our faith, that we have the faith of the Son of Man, Jesus, and the Son of God speaking. For he speaks his word in his house. Our bodies are unified by the voice of the Father, by the voice of the Son, crying out of the wilderness, crying out above all things, Abba Father, for the Father of Jesus and the life of the Word, having the same spirit of reconciliation. We've been reconciled in the Garden of Eden, manifesting the kingdom of heaven on the earth as the kingdom of God flows within us, having the same spirit of Jesus. And Jesus has given us the Father's blessing, who is our unified spirit speaking. Therefore, if you speak by faith in Jesus and the faith of the Word of God of the Father, you can clearly hear the God of the voice of fire, of baptism of Jesus, for he speaks himself in each one of you. Reconciliation now. We've been reconciled back to each other, and everything that once fell in the heavens and once fell on the earth, and all things to be made known as the things you can't see is only being spoken by the things you now know. And you now know the speaking and the preaching of the eternal house of God that Jesus Christ built through the Father and the Son on the foundation of the earth, and all of heaven speaking by God's Spirit. Fresh fire, God's alive in the born again preacher, speaking and teaching by faith in the word of God in Jesus and the word of his Father, Jehovah's word to Israel and the life speaking Gentiles and the Gentiles being one with the Jews, and everything that ever fell in heaven has been reconciled by Jesus. He's the high priest. He's the high archangel. He's God of creation of all new things. He's in the new heaven and the new earth forming his word, just as God formed his word out from the Virgin Mary. Came the Son of Man, came the word of God, sworn testimony to Adam and Eve of the earth. And God says, I love the earth, I love the ground, I love the rock and the seas and the animals and the trees. Just like the days of Noah, it's about to rain fire on your head. The stars in the heavens is prophesied. It's prophesied that one third of the stars above your head shall fall forth to the ground. And this day and that day shall be the same day when God says, I'm coming in my church on fire, baptized by the love of God in Christ, for the love of the Father and the love of the Son prophesies. We speak the future hope of the salvation of mankind. Now we stand on the common ground of Jesus Christ as he walked this earth. He came down as the Father manifested himself in the Virgin Mary, who fulfilled the prophecy to the Virgin Eve, who came from the bone of the first man, from the dust of the land of the sand, that your forefathers from him have been going back down to, from ashes to ashes and dust to dust. Each man has been going until today. Now today your faith is alive in the spirit, in the realm of heaven, in the realm of the kingdom of the throne room of God. Come boldly into the house of God. By grace it's been saved in faith in Jesus, not a man's works, least any man could boast, but by the gift of God and the word of God, by the Father of the same Spirit of Jesus. And Jesus is the word of the Father and the Father of the word of the Son, having the word of the children of the same mind, spirit, body right now as Jesus had. For Jesus is the body of the revelation of the demonstration of the power of God in our mouth, speaking by the truth. I'm thirsty. Jesus says, if you're thirsty, give me something to drink. Jesus said, I am the law of Moses. and I am the law of God. How can you not know God? They murdered him. They'll murder you. Not knowing God. God's alive in each one of us. We blood-washed, spirit-filled by Jesus. Jesus is the Word of the Father of the flesh, men and women, fully alive on the earth. Knowing we'll never die. We can't die. God's with us fully. The fullness of latter rain glory, the glorification of the earth. It's like gold, man. Like a gold child, golden child. Say, I'm the golden child of Jesus. Sitting together with God in Jesus. As Jesus was, he's God. He's God who manifested in the flesh, who's now alive in us, speaking. Jesus is speaking in us. It's how you receive the promise of his Father. Your spirit's eternal with the Holy Spirit, who reveals who Jesus was, who he is, and who will forever be his Word. He is the Word of God. He's the Word of God. And you start speaking the Word of God, you'll know it's Jesus. For he said, you'll know me, for I'm yours, you're mine. I called you before the foundation of the world, before any man was even formed, before the earth was, before there was sand and rocks and trees, before anything was, I am God. He's God. He loves you so much. He lives in your spirit, man. Through his Son, Jesus. The Father and the Son are the same in the Spirit, and so are you now. Believing and speaking by God's eternal Spirit, the only Spirit of Jesus and his Father. Speaking. You'll know God. Father's gift, your spirit knowing God. For God himself will speak out of your mouth, and you'll have to say to everybody who you are in Christ, I am he. He's alive in you and me the same as he was in Jesus. And Jesus has given us his spirit, his Father's blessing. That's who he is in each one of us now, every one of you. Gotta find him. He's in you. Open up your wings and fly for anything that fell in heaven against God the Father has been reconciled with God the Father through God the Son, Jesus, having faith. Just have faith in God. You'll know God. He's called you to be a preacher, a speaker, an orator of his union, of his faith. By his spirit dwelling in you right now. If you hear these words of these words are mine and these words are yours, for they're ours is the kingdom and the power and the goodness of God and the glory. For those who preach the good tidings, the good news to the people of the land, of the earth, of all of God's creation in the heavens and on the earth, and anything that it could be anywhere in hell, anywhere, only through Jesus have we all things been set free according to the Word of God and his kingdom. All things pertaining to the scriptures of the Holy Book, the Holy Bible. For the Word of God speaks out of our mouth by the Spirit of revelation, knowledge, understanding God the Father, through God the Son. The Holy Spirit in Jesus is the same Holy Spirit in his Father, who's our Father by the same Spirit. God speaks his Word. It's how you preach. It's how you speak. I'm sorry. It's how you speak God's Word through the blood of the Lamb of God, fully believing by faith in Jesus, having yet now received the Holy Spirit. The room that God builds us, each one of you, your enemy has still got God in Jesus. Your enemy still has the Spirit of God in Jesus. For Jesus purchased you and all of us by his own blood. That's God's blood. It's God's blood. Don't touch another one. Thou shalt not touch another one. There shall be no more shedding of innocent blood. God, the Father, will speak in your vocal cords. We were created to worship with God, and we're with God now through Jesus. For Jesus has given us his Spirit. The Father's Spirit is the promise of the land of heaven on the earth. And you now knowing God, all of us the same, wonderfully, uniquely made, right, standing together with our Father, who is the same Spirit that created everything before anything fell in heaven, anything on earth. Our future's now. Our future's here. Now, heaven's right now speaking, you understand? Understanding these things of the kingdom by the wisdom of God and the power of the Holy Spirit, having received the gift of Jesus. For Jesus is the Word of God, the Son of God, giving us the gift of the Father's blessing, having the same mind, body, and spirit as Jesus had. For Jesus is the Word of faith by the Father's blessing in us. For Jesus is the life of the Word of God, for the Father's blessing of the seed. Jesus is the seed of the promise of the Father to the first man. And out from that man, the bone of that man came the woman, and all of us are created from the sand of the dirt of the earth. And God says the earth ain't going nowhere. It's here now, and I am here. I created the earth and the fullness for me, thy Spirit. The only Spirit, only one way to know the Father is to come through the Son and believe fully in Jesus. He is the Spirit of God in you. He's the Spirit of God in us. You can't see. You open eyes but can't see. You blind generation, blind by the light of God. But yet a light affliction, says God, you shall suffer as Jesus suffered once for all mankind in the future hope of the salvation of men and women and children. For your children, the next generation behind me, Come on, must understand the things we're saying. But how can they hear God unless they don't know God, if they never read the Scriptures? But by the reading of the Scriptures of the Old Covenant is by the speaking of the Spirit of the New Testament, by the life of the eternal Spirit, knowing the completion of the Word of faith, by the faith of the living Spirit of God. For God's Spirit is in us all speaking. And if you speak God's Word, anointed by the Jesus, Jesus is the anointing of the Father's breathing in the breath of those who were chosen, as we all been chosen to be together with God in Jesus. He's the chosen one that we all saved from the curse of the land of death, and all death in heaven, and all death in hell, and everything that's ever died before today. I'm telling you right now, today is the day of salvation. It's the day of judgment, that you need to judge the speaking, the preaching. You need to judge the preacher, only the preacher. Don't judge. Don't look what anybody else is doing. Don't see what anybody else is doing and what they're doing. Don't worry about what they're doing. They just don't know. Don't worry about what they're doing. Don't judge them. Glory to God, don't judge them. Don't even look. Don't look that way. Only look the way. There's only one way to speak the host of the Most High God, having the revelation of the truth of the manifested glory of God, is speaking by the Holy Spirit, who is God, who is alive. You know where he is. He's alive in you. It's just much as in me. I believe, I received, and therefore I'm speaking by the Holy Spirit in Jesus, the resurrected Spirit of his Father. Now knowing all things, I don't mean to be a know-it-all. Jesus knows everything. God knows everything. He's everything within you. He's just as much in you as he is in me. I'm not looking at you out of man. I'm not looking at your sins you're doing. There are no sins in the kingdom. There is no other way to come into the life of the kingdom of God and see heaven on the earth speaking. When you start speaking, all of us are speaking. We were created to speak with God's Spirit as we are speaking with God's Spirit right now. He's in you. Say, Spirit of God's in me through Jesus. Jesus is the life of the Spirit of the Father and the Word, the testimony of your Spirit. Speaking together with God today, for today's your day to know God in spirit, fully believing in Jesus. Say, I'm fully believing in the blood of the Lamb of God, Jesus, fully believing by the Holy Spirit speaking. I do not speak my word, but just by my spirit. My spirit is unified with the Father, Jesus, and the Father of Jesus, and having the Father and the faith of the Son of God, and having the same Spirit. Right now, speaking. Who speaks his word? Jesus is the Father's blessing. He is the Spirit speaking. He's your Spirit speaking. He's your Spirit, my Spirit together. I love all of you. I love every man, woman, child. I love every angel. I love everything God says good with God through Jesus. And all the angels are rejoicing in heaven. Every dead thing's ever been dead and left their dead carcass body, and their body fell down to the ground which it came from, ashes to ashes and dust to dust. But by the resurrected power of the only power of God, by the only Spirit who created everything good, you got to see the future in the past now. Faith is alive speaking. God speaks. The Holy Spirit speaks out of every apostle, out of every chosen vessel, out of every chosen speaking one, speaking together with Jesus. Jesus is the union of the faith of the Father and the union of all things created that ever fell from the stars and coming down. Jesus came down. God sent his word. He sent his word. Jesus, who was the baby Jesus, came out the Virgin Mary. And then when she gave birth to a child, she gave birth to the King of Glory. She gave birth to God's Son who set us all free to know the future hope of the salvation of your generation behind you. Now today is your day to unify with the voice of your voice. Our voices are together unified. We were created to sing. We were created to worship. We were created to open up our mouth and let the Spirit of God do and have his way. Say, Spirit of Jesus, Spirit of the Father God, Spirit of the Son of God, have your way within me now speaking. Just have your way in my life. For I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I shall fear no evil. I shall walk together with God as God is now together with us, as God speaks his word by the Father's blessing through the Son of Man, Jesus, having received the same gift of the eternal Spirit speaking. Now, listen, every single one of you have the same gift of eternal life, the same Spirit. As I'm speaking to your spirit, confirming your spirit comes from the Father God, of the land of God, of the land of time, through the seed of the promise of Jesus. He is the seed of the promise to the Virgin Eve, who came from the bone of the first man, Adam, who separated from the snake of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. Now just let evil go away from you. Cut the old root down. You've been rooted and grounded in love by the love of Jesus Christ, who is God, who manifests himself in the Virgin Mary, who fulfilled the promise to the Virgin Eve, who is the dawn of the breaking of the new day by the spirit of Adam. The first Adam and the last Adam are now the same. They together now as we are together with God in the spirit. Say, I'm in the spirit now. You come through the door, Jesus. You knock on the door, you seek the kingdom. Jesus is the doorway to life and the only way to know your eternal spirit. For your eternal spirit, oh yeah, you do. You know God the Father through God the Son, having received now the same gift of eternal life. That's your spirit. Your spirit's in heaven right now on the earth. Right now, just don't look at your sin. Don't think about what you did yesterday. Don't think of anything else right now. Let this mind now be in you also in Christ, and you holy. Say, right now, I'm on holy ground, walking together with Jesus and the Father's blessing, having the same spirit. My sins are completely forgiven. I am completely right now blood washed. Right now, speaking by the Holy Spirit, by the water of life, by the Spirit of the resurrected power of God the Father, the same resurrected power of God the Son, having yet now the same Spirit of the eternal glorification of God's Word as we speak, anointed by God. Now, if you start speaking this way and you hear this way, we all can say and pray the same Spirit. That's Pentecost. That's when we all come in union faith of the same place where God is in his kingdom. Say, the realm of the kingdom of God's here in the Spirit. That's where you can walk in the Spirit right now. You can speak in the Spirit. I'm speaking in the Spirit. Say, I'm speaking in the Holy Spirit with Jesus. For Jesus given me the Holy Spirit of his Father and the promise through the Adam and Eve and the promise through the seed of Mary. And Mary is the mother of Jesus. And the promise has been fulfilled. And Jesus is the fulfillment of all things in heaven and on earth by faith alone in Jesus. Now, Jesus is your Spirit. He's given you himself as you know him by the Word. If you ain't never read the Bible, you just listen. You ain't got to crack a book now. You ain't got to open the book. Seven seals of Revelation's open. Open up your mouth and let God speak. You're anointed by God to speak his word when you find God in the scriptures. He is the man in the midst of each one of us who hear by faith, speak by faith, having received now and believing now the same spirit in Jesus is the same Holy Spirit of his Father, who's also the Holy Spirit in you, who's revealing the word of God, the written scriptures of the Father's blessing through the Son of God. And as he is now, so are we. Say, so are we. So are we. Who's we? All of us who hear in the Spirit, who blood washed by Jesus, having received the gift of his Father. I'm so thirsty. No more sacrifices of bulls, red bulls. No more innocent blood shedding, no red blood cells in your body. White blood cells released by the breath of God. God's revealing it. Say, Revelation's here. My whole body and my white blood count cells and my red blood cells are moving. God's word says, light be. By the Holy Spirit, say, light be. Light was, light is, light will forever be in God's spirit. In Genesis 1, by the earth and the fullness of time, in the beginning, God says, in the beginning, Jesus is the beginning, the end of the beginning of all things now new. You have the same spirit in the beginning. The same Holy Spirit's never changed. God says, say it, light be now. Light was, light is, light still is speaking. You're alive, remaining on the earth, full of God's Holy Spirit. You're the light of God, baptized by Jesus. For he speaks out of our mouth, those who are chosen in the chosen one, Son, by one seed, by one Father, by one breath, by one life, by one light, by one Spirit. You're set free. If you hear these words, you're free from the devil. You're free from the curse of the devil. You're free from Satan and the fallen angels. You're free from death itself. For Jesus Christ himself alone paid the death penalty of everything in heaven and on the earth as you now know God. Who has got God? Those who are born again in Jesus. We speak by the Holy Spirit, our unified spirit with the Father, the Son, by the resurrected Spirit of God. For God speaks out of his children. Say, I'm a child of God in Jesus. Yes, you are. We only preach the gospel, the good news gospel of Jesus. For the resurrected power of God's in our mouth. As Jesus places his word in our mouth, who is God? For just as he placed and breathed himself in the Virgin Mary and planted the seed, Jesus, as God became flesh, walked amongst men, and those who believe in him now, you have the flesh of the manifested glory of the Father. As we receive the gift of each one of us, there's a guy last night, you can test it out, playing football for the Buffalo Bills in the first, before the end of the first quarter. So God says, tell him the first quarter is over. Boom. That man made a hit on the Cincinnati Bengals. Higgins was the receiver. He hit his chest. He tackled him. He stood up and fell straight back dead. They begin to give him CPR for 9 minutes. An ambulance rushed him to the hospital. They shut the game down for the first time in NFL history. God says, tell my people I'm coming. I'm coming with fire. I'm coming with love. I'm coming in demonstration spirit. I'm coming in word. I'm coming in your life right now, says God. Those who believe in my son, Jesus, and they say these words, I believe in Jesus. For we are blood washed. We are fully spirit filled. We speak the language that God has known through every man, woman, and child from the history of the first man, Adam. For the first man came from the sand and the dust of the land that God's speaking in right now. You're blessed. You're highly favored. You're on the increase, says God. You're speaking together with God from the very beginning of time before that first man ever fell. For we all fallen. We all deserve the death penalty and separation from God of the Spirit. But only through Jesus Christ can you come back to God before man ever fell and before an angel ever fell. For through Jesus Christ, fully believing, everything has been reconciled back to the Father of lights. Us all having the same unified spirit. Pentecost is where how good it is for brothers and sisters on the earth to dwell together in unity with God by the Holy Spirit in Jesus. For Jesus is the life of the Word. He's the life of the eternal Spirit of God the Father. And through God the Son, Jesus, we've all been given the same Spirit. Knowing God today, even though we all sinned in our carnality, in our flesh, in our minds, and still do not knowing God, but those who now know God walk in the way, in the only way to manifest heaven on the earth with God is Emmanuel. Jesus has brought us back together with the first fruits of righteousness. For we did nothing of ourselves to get ourselves saved, lest we could boast in our flesh and our carnality. But we have been set free from our own self, of our flesh mind and our flesh man of sin. For our sin has separated us from God and manifesting death and sickness in each one of us. Now each one of us now knowing the truth of our salvation, Jesus Christ purchased every single one of us who are alive remaining on the earth today. For the sign and the sealed deliverance of God the Father's word and testimony comes through the blood sacrifice of knowing God and the Lamb that he required. Jesus is the Lamb required for you to come to God and say, Jesus Christ is my Lamb sacrifice for me to come back to God before Satan ever fell in heaven, before any angel or any third of the stars fell. For Jesus Christ is the recompense. He's a God of deliverance. He's a God. He's the bread to the children's life. He is the life of the eternal spirit ones who now fully believe and fully now know God only by the Holy Spirit. That's your spirit, my spirit, our spirit, together with God the Father, of God the Son, having received now God the Holy Spirit. For they, God the Father, and God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit, are one. Yet now so are we, who fully believe in God the Son, through God the Father, having received now the Holy Spirit of your life. Your spirit now speaking together in agreement with the two, God the Father and God the Son. Your spirit now agreeing with them that you've now received their spirit together with us and each one of you now who hear the word of God. For Jesus Christ is the life of the word of God. He's the life of the eternal spirit in you. As the Father blesses you to speak, that he speaks by his spirit unified with us in each one of you, as he is in us, the word of God. For Jesus is the life of the Father's word, and the Father's word of the same spirit through Jesus Christ, the Son of Man, who is the Son of God, who purchased all of us on the cross when he sacrificed himself, lay his own life down for the wickedness of all sins of every man, woman, and child that you see today. So do not look at the outer man who sins, but look into the inner workings of the Spirit. For God has released his Holy Spirit in every one of you, men and women, old or young, old or new. Jesus is the Word of God. He's the old and the new together. He is the law of Moses. He is the law of the Spirit in your life, knowing God. As we fulfill the commandments with God through Jesus, having now received his Spirit, God's Spirit, in the church, the unified body of each one of us, as Jesus is the head of the church, we are the body of the church, and Jesus is also the feet of our salvation. Jesus speaks by the Father's blessing with our spirit right out of our inner man. He comes from the top of your head, Jesus at the top, and he's also at the soles of your feet. If you believe in Jesus, he comes in the midst of you, fully believing in him. For this is the second coming and the appearing of Jesus in the church. The church is the full body of believers who can now see, hear, and speak together with God by the Holy Spirit, who is God, in each and every one of your lives as we're Christian. We're Christians who are born again through Jesus. For believing in Jesus, he is the life of the Spirit, of the Father to the Jews, the God of creation, and the word of faith to the Gentiles. And the Gentiles and the Jews became one. And God is now speaking out of every born again child and children. For by faith you speak God's word, and God's word is alive in your spirit. As Jesus said, you'll know me by my word, and you'll know my Father's testimony through me, and you'll know the Father through me, for you have received my spirit, and you will know me and the Father are one. On the day you speak my word by my spirit in you, you will tell the people who's speaking, Jesus is. For he's as much alive in you as he is in me, having received him. For Jesus is the life of the eternal spirit of the Father, who fulfilled the promise to Adam and Eve, who destroyed the wickedness of men, and Satan is underneath your feet. For today you sit together in the heavenly realm of the kingdom of God on the earth, just as he's the King of glory in heaven. For today we speak the perfected language of God, in every known language known to man, from the first man, Adam, and the first woman, in every seed that came out of her belly. For every one of us came from the first Adam of sin, but every single one of us have been set free by the blood of the Lamb of God, Jesus. For he fulfilled all things to the Father, for mankind itself, of the creation. For we're the new creations in Christ Jesus, now knowing God of the Spirit. For Jesus has given himself to us as we receive the fullness of his Spirit in our full body, in our full man, in each woman, in each child, fully believing by faith in Jesus, releases the power of the Father, the same spirit in the mind of those who are preaching. For we only speak God's word by the word of faith, by the Holy Scriptures, of the Holy Word, of the Holy Bible written down in the Holy Book. For the word was written to be spoken by God's Holy Spirit. It's never changed, but he changes our mind as we drink the wine. For the Spirit of God dwells in us now. He turns the water into wine at the great day of the Lord, of the future hope of mankind. Now you get a glimpse of everybody in heaven as he is right now, manifesting himself out of your innermost being as you flow in the river of living water, as you open up your mouth and let the word of God speak. For those who preach the word of the living God with the living spirit through Jesus have the Holy Spirit of his Father. And we now know all things were completed through the Son of Man, Jesus. For he has given you the life and the eternal spirit of your eternal life, now knowing God, who is now speaking. Who speaks? I say to you now, he does. If you look at me and you just see a man, then kill him. But if you see a Son of Man, born again by the Father, and you have the sound of the trumpet, for we were created to be the trumpet blast of the eternal kingdom, the life of Jesus, you will follow Jesus. You will know him, for you will walk in the way that he walked for you. For he knows your name greater than anybody else knows you. He knows you more than you know yourself. He knows every hair on your head. He knows every thimble. He knows every crevice on your body. For he died in his flesh for your flesh to be his by the Spirit. And if you have his Spirit, and you do, because he didn't die for one, he died for all. He died for everything. He's God who lays his life down for every creation that he ever made. Jesus Christ is King of all things made, right standing with the Father. How are you to not know what Jesus Christ and the Father has done unless you speak together with God today? As you know, all things were completed and fulfilled, as you now know God by faith alone in Jesus. Jesus is the Word of God. He's the life of the Spirit of God. He is God who's given himself to you. If you hear by faith, receive by faith the seed of the Father and the Son by the Spirit, you also know I'm telling the truth. Only by the Holy Spirit of truth, who has washed us, cleansed us by his blood, as we receive the water, the Spirit, to speak. And if you speak these words, you know these words were not just your words. They come from the one you fully believed in, for he gave himself to you. He gave you faith to speak, for you can do nothing without God. And he's given every one of you breath to breathe. And he says, speak now, forever hold your peace, for I've given you the keys to the kingdom. I've given you the word of God by my Spirit, and those who find God in the scriptures, for the scriptures are alive. For the word was written by the word of God, Jesus, and the sworn testimony of his Son, through his Father's agreement, and the contract that they made has been freely given to you to know God. But you must seek God yourself, for I can speak these words very clearly and you still not hear them. But once you hear them and have the word of God, fully believing in Jesus, you were chosen to be with him as you are now, in your hearing, in your very ears right now. The word of God is speaking to you. For we are all the word of God with Jesus. For his works is by his Spirit. You show me your faith, I'll show you his works. For he worketh within us all. For those who fully believe in Jesus, we know him for who God is. For through his Son, he shows himself to us. And by faith in him, we know the God we can't see. only knowing by faith the God we now know as he speaks, as he is now fully in us, as he intended to be in the first man. Through the last man, he's here. Who's here? God's Spirit. For this, I just heard a lightning. Today's a storm day, stormy day in Alabama. But you can have peace in the midst of the storm. You can have eternal peace. You can have the life of the eternal Spirit, knowing God through Jesus. And if you know God through Jesus and been blood washed, having received now the Holy Spirit, your unified spirit agreeing with the Son of Man, who is the life of the Son of God and the Father's Word through his Son, now knowing God of the Spirit. For I'm sold out, born again on fire, with the love of God in my heart. And I can only speak these words to you unless Jesus be real. For he is the Father's anointing, and he anoints your head with oil. The oil of gladness and the Spirit of God falling upon us now. Receive ye the Holy Spirit by faith in preaching and speaking his word. For all of you were called according to the principle of the word of God by the basic teaching, Jesus Christ. For Jesus is the Lamb of God, chosen before time itself. For time was created for man to live in and for God to live through man. But man, not knowing God, has destroyed each other, causing the curse of death to be upon their head, which over 2,000 years ago, that penalty has already been paid in full. But those who are now living on the third day, and you are the third man, the third temple, that God built not through the hands of man, but by through the hand of Jesus. So we're at the right hand of fellowship, sitting at the right side, the Jordan River. For the Jordan represents the Spirit and the blood of the Lamb of the covenant of God. For in the New Testament life of Christ, we speak, cross to the other side. Have faith in God through Jesus, having received now the eternal Spirit of God our Father, of God the Son. For the Holy Spirit himself reveals Jesus. He's the life of the Word of the Father, having received the eternal Spirit of God, who's alive remaining on the earth when Jesus comes back. For he comes back in his church by his Spirit. He's the door of life. He's the life of the doorway to the kingdom of heaven. For the kingdom of God is a seed placed down in the midst of every single one of you who were called and chosen before you were ever born, before your mother ever received her seed, the seed of your daddy. Only through Jesus can you now know the seed has been planted in you by Jesus. For he knew you on the cross, on the tree that God made, from the wood that God was from, before man ever was. God still is. He was before man. He'll be after man when man destroys himself through the mind of the fallen one, for the mind of the flesh man, not knowing God's the devil. Now, when we know who the devil is and we know who God, who Jesus is, we have been freed from the devil, of the mind of the carnality of war. For we love greater. We give more. For through one man, Jesus, we now know God. For Jesus is God, who manifested in the flesh by his own word, by his own testimony, and by his own Spirit. He is the God, the Messiah, to the Jews, who saved also the Gentiles and all the Romans, even though they went to war. For the temple was destroyed, just as Jesus said, and they shall not build another. For if they build another one, it's a false image that people worship in Mecca. There's only one true God. His name is Jesus Christ, the Son of God, who set us free to boldly preach his word, and we are willing to die by our own brother's sword. For the sword of the Spirit's our mouth, and our mouth preached from the depths of the grave of heaven. For those who murdered and slain the Lamb of God, Jesus, are the only one God is going to pay the death penalty to. But those who are now speaking by the gift of grace, having the full measure of faith in the land of the living of the earth and the resurrected seeds of the word of God, we are the harvest by the Spirit of King Jesus. For the Spirit of God dwells in our heart, knowing Him, as we are manifested in the glorification of God's Word, glorifying the Father, Jehovah, for the Father of all creation, of Israel, of Mecca, of every man, woman, and child that was ever been born on this earth. We come now in the name of Jesus Christ, for He is the army of God and the host of the army of the angels. He is leading us out of temptation. He has delivered us from evil. For Thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory. For the Father blesses us with the Son as we are His children, heirs to the throne of eternity, joint heirs to the house of King David. For King David was a man of flesh just as we. So was Elijah. So was Enoch. But as Enoch was and was not, yet now so are we. For I was a man not knowing God. But through the man Jesus, the Son of Man in the flesh, as He manifested Himself, He's now manifesting Himself in each one of us now, who are ordained by God to open up our mouth and let the Father of the Word of God and the life of Jesus Christ speak by the anointed one of the Spirit. For our spirit now, knowing the Father of lights, who said light be, is still speaking. For the Word of God was chosen to be in the last chosen vessels of the generation of the last known tongue. For the last tongue is the first tongue of God. For throughout time, ages, and seasons, God has had patience with man. But His patience has run thin and run out. For you still bow your knee to the west and to the east. But the God has separated you from the east to the west. Of the northern gates of the south for temple. You shall rise from the dirt. You shall rise again with the first fruits of Jesus Christ, having gift the spirit of reconciliation. For the repentance of men and women have now come to fruition. For God says, time is running out and is short. For I will raise the dead in Christ first. For they ever die, I shall speak out of their mouth. And when I speak out of their mouth, I speak out of their mouth through my Son Jesus, and His Son now alive in them. For they are my children who believe fully in my word, having the same spirit. I am thy God. I'm the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. I'm in the New Testament life of my Son. Those who are crucified with my Son on the tree of life have been separated from the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. And those who speak by the baptism of love and the baptism of God the Father through God the Son, being baptized by fire, being baptized by the Holy Spirit, who have you heard now today in your ears? For may your ears bleed and may your mind know that you've been reconciled in the mind of the reconciliation of the word of faith and generation to generation of the genealogy of God. For God is spirit, life, form, and truth, and He's forming His word in the born again believers who have no choice but to open up their mouth and choose Jesus. For those who choose Jesus choose to die in their flesh to their common man. As we rise up together in the Spirit, sit together with our God, open up our mouth and let our Father speak by His Spirit. My spirit speaking together with God. I was sacrificed on the Lamb of God when God said, you are the Word of God and the Word of God is alive in you. So when the Word starts speaking and walking around among men, you better know it's the end of the last and the last of the first of man. Mankind, for God says man has suffered long enough and is suffering with one Son through Jesus Christ. You are now in contemplation. You are now being condemned only in the flesh, but there is no condemnation in the Spirit, for all men have died, fallen by their own sword in their own mouth. Tell them who you are. My name is Lance Sean. I'm born again through Jesus, given the name of God to speak His word, a sharp two-edged sword piercing my bone, marrow, and flesh as I open up my mouth and let God out the box. He is the temple of the Most High God. We're the house where God built in Jesus. We're the body of God, the Christ King, the anointed one Son, having His flesh, having His body, His mind, having His spirit, and vengeance is mine, says God. Each one fall down, not knowing my Son Jesus, but those who know my Son stand firm on the firm foundation of the written scriptures of the Holy Word of God, the Holy Bible speaking. For we don't speak our word, we speak the living word of the resurrected power of our unified spirit. Our spirit knowing the Father of Jesus and the life of the Spirit in us. For we are now coming forth out of our mouth, the word of God, out of the mouth of the sword of the Spirit. If you hear these words, you hear the word of the Father through the word of the resurrected power of the Spirit of the Son of God. For Jesus is the life of the Father in the children of the Most High God. There's one true God. There's only one way to know God, and that's for you to speak. You open up your mouth, whether you are dumb or whether you are numb or whether you can see or blind, having ears to hear, eyes to see. If you got a tongue in your spirit, let your spirit speak, for your spirit's blood washed. spirit-filled and baptized by the love of God in Christ Jesus. For God loved the whole world, the whole wide world, and everybody ever to have been born out of the seed of a man and out of the womb of a woman. But God has reconciled us back to the very beginning of time, before the angels even fell, sitting together in the kingdom of God with God, for only through Jesus, knowing the full completed book of the story of your life. I'm not lying. I'm testifying with the Lion of the tribe of Judah. I'm a new creation in Christ, co-heir together with Jesus, joint heir to the house of David, to the house of Jesse, to the chosen one, Jesus. He was the Messiah who was prophesied in the old. He is the life of the Spirit in the New Testament, life of revelation, now giving you the genesis of the word of God by the Spirit. And if your spirit now speaking together with God through Jesus has a gift of grace to open up your mouth and speak, who can forbid water? For water is now speaking. For a man that's born again by water and spirit speaks. Who speaks the word of God? We all do who are born again through Jesus, having the Father's Spirit and the mind of the reconciliation of the word of God. Okay, thank you, baby. I got caught up again. Fresh fire. I'm getting off of here. But life is in the word. And life is in the spirit. And those who are blood washed by Jesus only, having received the gift of reconciliation, your spirit now speaking. We speak the word of faith by the faith of the written scripture, the Lamb's Book of Life. For the word written in the Holy Bible is now speaking by his Spirit, the author and the finisher of our faith. And the word of faith in which we now speak, I'll see you soon. Fresh fire. Share the gospel. Sow a seed into the teaching and the preaching with Jesus. For the poor shall be rich and the rich shall be poor. For God is coming like a thief in the night. He is coming in the day walkers, the tongue talkers, the Pentecostal believers of the church foundation, the apostolic and only ones who you were called before the foundation of the world to be together with God in Jesus. Jesus is the life of the Spirit of those who speak God's word in the fullness of time, in the last and the first day together with God on the earth. Just as Jesus is the head of the church in heaven, just as he's the head of this body, the full body in each one of you now, by the Spirit, fresh fire. We'll see you soon. I'm coming with fire. I'm coming with love, and I'm coming with word by the Holy Spirit speaking. Fresh fire. Receive the gift of God by the Holy Spirit of Jesus. You'll know God. Only way you'll know God is you'll speak. Then you'll know God speaking. Fresh fire.